Thank you for your interest in spanning backup for Salesforce. In this video, we'll detail how to install and configure spanning into your Salesforce instance to ensure that your data is backed up successfully. To begin, open a new browser window and navigate to spanning.com/salesforcetrial. Fill out the requested information and then click Start My Trial. You are then presented with an overview of the installation and configuration process. On the right side of the screen, you'll see the option to download the installation guide. We recommend you download it since it details all the installation and configuration steps. Next, install spanning into your Salesforce org. Please note that there are two separate managed package installation links, one for production or development orgs and one for sandbox orgs. So please ensure that you use the correct link that corresponds to your Salesforce environment. You will then be asked to log into your Salesforce account as the system administrator user. Please note that in order to install Spanning Backup for Salesforce, you'll need to be a System Administrator user. When you begin the installation process, select Install for Admins Only, and then click Install. When the installation is complete, you'll see a confirmation screen with the text, Installation Complete. Click the Done button at the bottom of the screen, and you are then returned to your Salesforce org. Now that you have Spanning successfully installed into your Salesforce org, the next step is to configure the application so that Spanning can back up your data. Please note that these steps apply to Salesforce Classic. First, we'll make a change to the installed Spanning application. In the Salesforce Setup menu, expand the Manage Apps option, and then select Connected Apps from the sidebar navigation menu. Next, click the Edit button next to the Spanning Backup link. In the OAuth Policies section, change permitted users to admin approved users are pre-authorized, so that all admin users in your org are automatically granted access to spanning. When done, click Save. Next, we'll make some edits to the user profiles in your Salesforce org. In the sidebar menu, expand the Manage Users option and select Profiles. Click the System Administrator profile and then click Assign Connected Apps. Click the Edit button and then add both Spanning Backup and Spanning Restore. This will enable all users with the System Administrator user profile to access Spanning's Backup and Restore app and also the on-page Restore functionality. It is common practice for Salesforce organizations to clone the default System Administrator profile and assign users to a custom administrator profile rather than the default one. Please repeat this step for administrator profiles that need to access Spanning Backup for Salesforce. When done, click Save. Next, navigate back to the System Administrator profile and click Visual Force Page Access. Ensure that both Spanning Backup and Spanning Restore are listed here. If not, click the Edit button for this section and add both Spanning Backup and Spanning Restore from the Available section. In this section, you will also see an option for Spanning Universal Restore, which is an optional restore functionality that Spanning offers. Feel free to add this feature as well. We'll cover setting up this functionality later in this video. The final required step in setting up Spanning Backup is to log into the application for the first time, so that Spanning can validate it has the correct authorization to back up your data. Click the plus button near the top of your screen to see all available tabs in your Salesforce environment. Select Spanning Backup. At this point, if you run into any issues, refer to the Knowledge Base article linked above. You are then asked to choose the region in which you would like your backed up data stored. You can choose from North America or Europe. Please note that once selected, this setting cannot be changed. When ready, click the Continue to Spanning button in the upper right corner of your screen and confirm your selection. Congratulations and welcome! You are now ready to start protecting your Salesforce data. All daily backups are queued at 12 noon GMT, but since you just installed spanning, there is no data backed up yet. We recommend initiating an on-demand backup right away, so that spanning can begin backing up the data in your Salesforce organization. Please note, before starting your initial backup, that when spanning backs up your Salesforce data, we use your Salesforce org's API calls to back up the data in your account. Spanning allows you to configure the number of API calls that are made against your Salesforce organization each day to ensure that we don't use all of your daily allotted calls. By default, the API limit is set to 15% of the total number of API calls for your organization. If you're performing an initial backup or have a large organization, this default number of daily API calls may not be enough to complete your backup. In this case, we would recommend increasing your daily API limit call by clicking the Change API Limit button at the bottom of your spanning dashboard. Your initial backup may take some time to complete, as we are backing up everything in your Salesforce org. After this initial backup completes, all subsequent daily backups will be much faster to complete, because spanning performs incremental backups, meaning we will only capture the new and changed data from the previous backup. You may be able to set your API limit lower once the initial backup has completed. You're all set. No additional configuration is required to ensure that your data is protected. Spanning does offer additional optional configuration settings that will allow you to enable on-page restores within your Salesforce environment, set a custom time for your daily automated backups, and adjust other admin settings. Since Spanning Backup is tightly integrated with Salesforce, we are able to offer the ability to restore field-level data of specific records of any object type directly from the record page in your Salesforce environment. We call this feature Universal Restore. It makes it easy to enable end users to self-restore data they have permission to edit, and for admins to perform very quick comparisons and field-level restores. To enable the Spanning Universal Restore button, follow these steps. Go to your Salesforce Setup page. In the sidebar navigation menu, go to Customize, Home, Homepage Components. Click New, and then Next. Set the name to Universal Restore, and select Visual Force Area as the type, and then click Next. Here, set the component position to Narrow Left Column, the Visual Force page to Spanning Universal Restore, the height to 32 pixels, and leave the other two boxes unchecked. When done, click the Save button. Next, we're going to add this newly created component to your page layouts so it appears on the record pages. In the sidebar menu, navigate to Customize, Home, Homepage Layouts. Click on the Edit button next to the layout that you would like to add the button to. The default layout is Dashboard Homepage Default. Here, check the box next to Universal Restore and then click the Next button. Confirm that Universal Restore is listed here in the narrow left column list and arrange it in your preferred order. When ready, click the Save button. Finally, in the sidebar menu, navigate to Customize User Interface and click the box next to Show Custom Sidebar Components on All Pages. Then click Save. Now, if you return to any record page in your Salesforce environment, such as an account, you'll see the Universal Restore button available on the left side of your screen. Please note that this feature is currently available in Salesforce Classic and is not yet available in Lightning. For more information on how this Universal Restore button works, please watch the demo video, which is linked above. Additionally, if you would like, you can enable the Universal Restore button for all standard users in your org so that they can self-restore records that they have permissions and rights to edit. To do so, follow these steps. In the Salesforce Setup sidebar menu, navigate to Manage Users, Profiles. Click on the Standard User Profile. Select Assign Connected Apps, click the Edit button, and then add Spanning Restore to the Enabled column. When done, click Save. Next, return to the Standard User Profile Overview, select Visual Force Page Access, and then click the Edit button. Move over Spanning Universal Restore to the Enabled column, and then click Save. Now, all standard users in your org will have access to the Universal Restore button. To easily access your Spanning Backup for Salesforce account, we recommend that you add Spanning Backup to your default tabs. To do this, click the plus button in your tabs, and then click the Customize My Tabs button. Here, move Spanning Backup from the Available Tabs section to your selected tabs. When done, click Save. By default, all daily automated backups are queued at 12 noon GMT. But if you would prefer for these daily backups to occur at a different time, you can easily do so by following these steps. In Spanning Backup, click the Settings tab and scroll down to the Backup Schedule section. Click the Edit Backup Time button and then toggle the switch to enable a custom time backup. Next, choose the time in your local time zone when you would like your daily backups to start. When ready, click the Save button. Finally, here in the Settings tab, you are also able to set a few additional settings for your account. You can choose whether or not to have Spanning Backup activity post to your org's chatter feed, and how often to receive backup status reports via email in the notification section. Additionally, in the dashboard configuration section, you can choose which four object types are shown on the dashboard. By default, these four object types are accounts, contacts, leads, and opportunities, and show the number of new, updated, deleted, and undeleted records backed up for each object type. You can edit which four object types are shown by clicking the Edit Settings button. That's it! You have now completed the installation and configuration process. If you've started your initial backup as recommended earlier, you'll get a notification once it's complete. Please see the admin guide for additional features and functionality information, and go view our use case videos linked above to learn how to perform common restores, how to export your data, and how to compare metadata using spanning. If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to reach out to our support team at support@spanning.com. We're always happy to help. Thanks for watching.